Hello children, okay, we discussed in the previous videos about the rise of the CCP party and about the KMT party also we discussed, and here when the Japan occupied the China country and how did they fought against the Japan country and what are the conditions under the Japanese rule and how did Japan withdraw from the China country and after withdrawal of Japan country in the China from the China country and what were the condition, how did the CCP party, okay, I mean about civil war we discussed, and how did CCP party eventually came to power also we discussed. Okay, now in this video we are going to discuss about after came to power, okay, that CCP party established a new democracy nana. Okay, the CCP party established a new democracy in the year 1949. Okay, so now let us discuss. That means a new government was established in the China country nana. Okay, so now let us discuss about that new government. Okay, we came to understand that here in the China country, nana, CCP party successfully came to power and successfully CCP party planned to establish a new government. Nana. This new government is known as the People's Republic of China. This new government is known as the People's Republic of China. People's Republic of China. Nana. Okay, so this is a new government. Okay, this new government is established based upon the principle of new democracy. See, CCP party came to power and CCP party established a new government in the China country in the year 1949. Okay, this new government is called as the People's Republic of China, and this new government based upon the principle of new democracy. Here, new democracy means it is a principle. This principle was an association of inclusion of all, also I mean this new principle was an association of all social classes. That means in this new government, Nana, that new government planned to include all kind of people in the government process. Simply here, this government established socialist government. Okay, socialist government. That means here, this socialist government given priority to all the people. I mean, this government decided to include all the people in the process of development. Okay, so here now we came to understand that the new government was established, and this new government started fulfilling its promises. See, already we know that the major promises of CCP party was twin agenda of CCP party is land reforms and nationalization. So as per its promise, Anna, this party promised to implementation of land reforms and also, okay, so as per that, once came to power, CCP party started large scale of land reforms. Anna. So in order to implement this land reforms, Anna, the CCP party first it confiscated the land of the landlords. Confiscated the land of the landlords means here, confiscation means here, take over the land of the landlords. Okay, so in that way, now it decided to take over the land of the landlords and wanted to implement the land reforms. So not only that, Anna, even this party, I mean this new government also managed to enact many laws for the welfare of the women, Anna. For example, to protect the women and to protect their rights, to protect the rights, and at the same time, Anna, for abolition of polygamy also the government passed laws. Okay, by passing this laws, Anna, the government try to enable women to assume new roles in the society and to enjoy equal status along with women in the various fields, Anna. Okay, so now let us discuss.